the Bears beat Tampa Bay. Welcome to the finals, the men's final. You haven't missed a thing yet. And those of you who watch New England beat Green Bay, welcome to the National Tennis Center. And you're looking at the first point of the men's finals. We had a rainstorm earlier, and the reason for the delay was the court was wet. Delay in getting started.
Certainly stepped into that second serve, didn't he?
McEnroe is 26 years old, Lindell 25. John has been in 11 Grand Slam finals. Lindell's been in 8. Lindell 6-2, McEnroe 5-11.
Of course, John has won here 4 times and Wimbledon 3. Yvonne has only won once. That was in the French Championships last year when he beat McEnroe, who had a 2-set-to-love lead.
Grand Slam meetings, the series is tied at 3 apiece.
30.
What we're looking at here is where Lendl's going to actually hit the ball on the return. See if he moves it.
40 love.
Missing those returns in the first game, but he has to keep trying that, I believe, and take those chances. As we get into the game, his reactions will quicken up.
40. Hey, McEnroe.
Love game from McEnroe. He wins the first game of the first set. Temperature 81 degrees, humidity 65%. Evening showers in the forecast, wind northwest 5 miles an hour. Temperature on court much more livable than it was yesterday or the day before when it was up over 110.
It is humid, but that rainstorm that came through certainly cooled things down. You can expect to see a lot of that. If Lendl does not get his first serve in, McEnroe will be coming most of the time.
Lendl takes a lot of time.
First 6 points to McEnroe.
Fifteen.
So much for that. This shot from the Goodyear blimp. Thunderstorms in the area. But right now, sunshine on the court.
Double break point.
Yoko Ono.
She's out here every year. Son obviously loved the tennis.
What? First serve.
Double break point.
I wonder if Lendl might try to serve and volley on this second serve.
It would surprise me.
Game McEnroe.
You never know. Right. McEnroe gets a break.
That's the pressure of knowing that McEnroe was going to chip
McEnroe
it or hit
leads
it and run to the net behind it. He tried to overserve it.
At Wimbledon, Lendl did not serve well, and he kept trying to serve harder and harder. And, you know, the logic for us normally would be take
quiet,
a little speed off, add a little spin, start getting some in and build your confidence back up, and then start adding more pace. If he serves badly, he's going to be in huge trouble.
I know Roche said to him, you're hitting a lot of your second serves into the net. Why don't you give it a little bit more height and a bit more spin? And he said, well, I'll hit it harder and that'll get it going. Roach, you didn't know what to say after that.
There is no answer.
Well, he also served over 20 doubles, as I recall, in that particular match.
The one with LeConte, mm-hmm. where he lost in four sets.
Is playing in white today. He's been playing in Battleship Gray throughout the tournament.
Ah! More like Thunderstorm Gray. Speaking of thunderstorms.
Leon Lipp, our umpire. I believe a word you used earlier, Nuke, was flexible, and that's something that Ivan is not very good at. He gets set in his mind during a match, he's going to do it a certain way, and that's it.
How about this? Those of you who watched Minnesota upset the Super Bowl champions, San Francisco 49ers 28-21. Welcome to the men's finals at the U.S. Open 1985. It's McEnroe 3-0 over Yvonne Lindell. This first set. The Miami Dolphins, 49ers opponents in last year's Super Bowl, also lost today. Houston 26-23 over the Dolphins. Two big upsets.
There's another Phelps upset.
You're right.
Looked like it was just out to
me. I thought it was out.
I think it gave Yvonne a bit of a scare.
Normally when you have a ball, a really good play on a ball, you don't let it go. I think it's going to be very close. If it's going to be way out, obviously you just let her fly.
The natural inclination for Lindell on this type of point would have been to hit the forehand, wait till the next one comes back and drive it again into the next corner. In this match, he's decided to come to the net behind those drives and rely on his volley. Getting off to a bad start like this, Tony, it'll be interesting to see if Lindell will keep up with that aggressive game plan or revert back to what comes naturally.
Find Tony Roach sitting in the stands and get a signal for the curveball, you know, some change up or something.
Game, Lindell. McEnroe leads 3-1.
McEnroe has been serving much better than he did yesterday against Vilander.
Hadn't lost a point on his serve yet.
Makes it 4-1, McEnroe. First ace by Lindley took a little something off of that.
That still goes pretty fast.
Sure does.
So if you do that and get a much higher percentage, then you're certainly going to be more effective. We'll see a fair number of double faults out of Lendl today because of the pressure McEnroe puts on your second serve.
Watch McEnroe moving in now, inside the ball. It's an awful pressure to have to face, isn't it? And then you start thinking, well, gee, I better get my first serve in.
The other thing is, too, that when it felt like Lendl takes a pretty big swing at it, a pretty long backswing, and when you rush like that, you don't have time to make that good, that long swing and be accurate and consistent with it.
That would be a good tactic, Tony, to serve and volley 30, maybe a third of the time. It's not a...
Or half, and just mix it up some.
Yeah. Just keep him guessing a bit. I think a serve and volley on the second serve every now and then will keep him guessing too. Got to do something. You can't just let the opponent chip and charge you all day.
And Macro's not chipping either. He's drilling it and coming
right in. That is a heck of a return, you know, when you're moving forward like that and to be able to generate that amount of power.
McEnroe 7-3 Grand Slam finals. Lindell 1-6 won the French.
He read that perfectly then.
U.S. Open finals. McEnroe's won 4 and lost none. Yvonne, this is his 4th U.S. Open final. He has not won one yet.
Up.
Jane Lindahl.
4-2 McEnroe in the first.
McEnroe leads 4-2.
See McEnroe call for an extra ball. He looks and he wants to get the ones that are the fastest. I mean, the nap is not puffed up on as much, so they can serve it better.
9 U.S. Opens for John McEnroe. 50-4, his record.
Didn't Jimmy Connors break the record during this tournament? He, Vic Sacious had won 75 matches.
Right. Jimmy has 77 now. That's the record among the men.
Yvonne's parents, both tennis players.
A
shot like McEnroe just hit there, he took very little backswing. And do you think he gets a lot of power, Tony, with that loose restring? He's got it strung, a mid-sized racket strung at about 45 pounds, which is incredibly loose.
No question, he gets the slingshot or trampoline effect. Ball sort of sinks in and is thrown out. That's why he doesn't have to take as big a swing. It amazes me how he can control the ball as well as he does.
Yvonne started to argue and then quickly changed his mind. 40 love. Five straight years, McEnroe has been seeded number one.
Well, Lindell still hasn't won a point, but he's played two good points in that game, in this game so far. Backhand return, although it missed, would have given him a lot of confidence.
That would have too.
And the passing shot he tried earlier in the game that hit the top of the net and just bounced out, was well hit also.
Okay, McEnroe.
That makes it 5-2 McEnroe in the first set.
First serve. A 15.
That was a little ambitious on McEnroe's part.
15 all.
See, both feet off the ground here. Doesn't make a deep return. It's inside the service line. Grandmother could pass you from there.
'15-30.
That's a tough play.
I tell you.
Just drop the ball a little short and the baseline rally, it's a winner. Very confident shot to be able to bring that down the line.
Now here's the real challenge now, the kind of a second serve does Lindell go after. You see McEnroe probably trying to come in behind the return.
30 all.
He had it in mind.
Put a little bit extra spin on that one, Lindell. It jumped up, kicked up at McEnroe's racket. A little quicker than he thought.
Well, we've been doing a lot of talking about McEnroe and how well he's playing. He's only has one service break. Lendl holds here. It'll be McEnroe serving at 5-3, so it hasn't been a blowout by any means.
Those of you who watched the Cardinals beat the Browns in overtime 27-24, welcome to the finals of the U.S. Open of 1985, Yvonne Lendl against John McEnroe. The action's in the first set, Lendl serving at 2-5.
Went to the slice approach shot that time. Good variation. It's when you see the racket head come under the ball, put slice on it, makes the ball bounce very low. It's difficult to play passing shots off that. See how good McEnroe's approach shots have been up till now, because if he drops them at all short,
yeah,
Lendl will pass him.
It's a bit of a kamikaze, Ray. There's a Davis Cup captain, Arthur Ashe. It's a situation where you're on the move, you're coming in, and you're going to come in whether you make a good shot or a bad shot. You just hope that you make something pretty good. Volley.
Advantage Lendl.
Key here is how deep this ball goes and how far back McEnroe is behind the baseline. It's pretty tough to pass anyone when you're 8, 10, 12 feet behind the baseline. It's because of a good deep shot by that gentleman.
He had him dead.
He had the right idea, didn't he?
Sure did.
Well, he had other options, too.
McEnroe leads 5-3.
5-3. McEnroe leads. We look down at the Throgsnake Bridge over the Long Island Sound.
15 seconds.
Both players going to the towel, and McEnroe to serve for the first set. Incredibly, he has not lost a point on serve yet. And this is his fifth service game.
For that streak.
Low 15.
Nothing lasts forever.
I bet you do.
Yeah.
Love 30.
First real test for McEnroe here, and the point you made a while ago, Tony, if he were to lose his serve here, it would be not good for him because he's dominated this set so far.
Well, it seems like it, but he's, like, again, he only has the one service break. He's been awesome on his own serve.
Point for Lendl. Love 40.
Excellent return from Lendl then, and he's adopted a stance just about a foot further back than what he was in the first few games. And it seems to be working for him. He's not quite on the baseline by the time he hits the ball. First few service games, he was on the baseline or inside the baseline trying to hit it.
And really didn't get many of them back in play.
Missed it. Lendl.
Lendl gets his break. McEnroe leads 5-4, first set. Yvonne Lendl has just come off a service break and will be serving to get even.
First four times McEnroe served, he didn't lose a point, and then he was broken at love. So back on serve in this first set. First serves, points one. Lendl normally tosses the ball a little bit higher than you need to toss it, so he's sitting as it's coming down. Appears he may not be tossing it quite as high as he normally does, but it's still higher, I think, Newt, than you really need.
It's dropping a foot and a half or
right.
So before he actually hits it. When McEnroe serves in the next game, we'll have a look at his toss, see where he hits it. It's been a funny first set, hasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Good control here off the half volley. 40.
This part's easy. McEnroe can't get back in time. He just wisely makes a short backswing and punches it into the open court. It's a little smoother stroke that time by Lendl, not as flailing and wild as he was early in the set. The Rocket, Rod Laver, the only man in the history of this game to win the Grand Slam twice. Don Budge, the first one to do it. That, of course, you have to win the Australian, the French, Wimbledon, and the U.S. Supposed
to be
done the same year.
Used to be in the same year.
Right.
They sort of revised that a little bit.
Game, Lendl.
5-5.
Now you see a dogfight because Lendl settled down.
5-5.
He's into it now.
And the crowd's starting to get into it, too.
That may be one of the strangest first sets I've seen so far. What was it, 12 of the first 13 points were won by McEnroe? He won his first four service games to love.
How about the women's final yesterday, the first set?
That went up and down, didn't it?
5-love.
5-5.
Take a look at the toss here from McEnroe, Nuke.
Yeah, let's see where he actually makes contact with it. Big rotation, isn't it?
Yeah. See, it's barely
just
dropping.
Just started to drop.
There is no advantage to tossing it higher than you can reach fully extended.
I find a lot of club players have a hitch in their serve because their ball toss is too high. They have to hold their racket behind their head while they wait for the ball to come down.
I think it's a lot of the reason they drag that back foot up and then have to sort of wait until the ball comes within reach.
What?
First serve.
Good shot. Great touch.
40 long.
Looks so easy to do, some of the shots he plays.
All the good ones make it look easy.
He leads 6-5 first set.
We'll be back at the U.S. Open after this word from your local station.
Lucky break for Lendl.
15 long.
When you're serving to save the first set, nothing better could happen here. McEnroe was sort of on it. He was looking for the down the line backhand passing shot. A lot of people think that that's the one Lendl prefers to hit. Scored him three or four times on that second court by serving the second serve a little harder and nice and deep and into the body on the forehand side. It's 0 for 3 in this game so far on first serves.
Point away from a tiebreaker.
All the tiebreak, McEnroe serving first.
Of course, in the tiebreakers, the first player to reach 7 points with at least a 2-point advantage. The McEnroe entourage.
McEnroe has won 7 of 11. He'll serve 1 point.
He won a crucial one in the fifth set against Shlomo Glickstein in the first round. He wouldn't be here.
That's right. Tony Roach in the bottom left of your picture and Tatum O'Neill behind him.
1-0, Lendl.
Tony Roach, former Australian Davis Cup, and now coaching Ivan Lendl.
Yeah, McEnroe covered a little territory on that point.
He really did. I was looking for Lendl to come in about halfway through. He hit a really good forehand. I thought he might follow it in. But he won the point anyway.
Now he'll serve 2 points. 11-4 in tiebreakers. Second ace.
He took a long time to serve that ball, too.
He's very slow, very deliberate.
Bounces the ball 4 times, and then he'll be ready to go.
Gets the sawdust out.
A little routine, strings.
Ivan made a good half volley that time. He didn't hit it hard, but he got it deep.
3-0, Lendl.
McEnroe hitting off the back foot.
This would be a real bonus for Lendl if he could win this set. Sure didn't look like it about half an hour ago.
Sure didn't. Like he was going to be blown away.
Long set. They've almost been playing for an hour.
Kind of late start because the court was wet.
Duty topspin on that forehand made it dip real quickly. He's looping swing. Watch the reaction. Yes, sir, he says. 4-1 Lendl. Yvonne's parents. That'd be tough sitting out there watching your
boy, would it?
One of your kids playing in a major championship. My dad got a little gray prematurely. Players change ends after 6 points.
5-1, Lendl.
Lendl leads at 5-1.
I don't know that there's anyone playing that hits the forehand any harder than Ivan does. There's another look. He steps around. This is what he likes to do best. Overpowered McEnroe. We'll see what his reaction is. Oh, yeah, let's get to the other side and get at it.
Super volley that was.
Quite a comeback by Ivan Lendl, and he wins the first set.
Now, is it? I beg your pardon. He's got 5.
6-1. 6-1. Lendl.
He's five got 5 set points. It was an excellent first serve, too. Again, not hit as hard as he can hit it, but with plenty of speed on it, backed it up perfectly.
Okay to say it. First set to Ivan Lendl. He wins it 7-6.
So Lendl has won the first set.
Love.
Hour and 1 minute for that first set.
Game, Lendl.
Lendl wins the first game of the second set.
Done two things. He's made two changes. One is he's standing back a little farther, as we mentioned earlier, and he's also not taking the same big wild swing, a more controlled swing at it, using the speed that's coming from McEnroe's serve and trying to get good direction on it.
It's a pretty good swipe at that one.
15.
Oh, very confident right now.
He had won 9 straight points. But he missed that one.
Goodbye.
Do
you think Lendl's got a good backhand lob, Tony? I don't think it's that accurate.
I've never thought of it that way, really, but... He's certainly a well-rounded and a complete player.
Oh, good volley. Well, Coach Roach would be pretty proud of the volley he's doing right now. That's an area of the game they've been working on. And
here's a lob that worked this time. Drove McEnroe away from the net. In comes Yvonne. There was a good deep volley.
Coach Roach. That's got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
There was a very famous Coach Roach in Los Angeles. Used to work with Jack Kramer. A lot of people out there who are no longer with us, but... He was a good one.
About the effect on McEnroe, Tony, having lost that first set when he too must have thought it 5-3 when he hadn't lost a point on serve. Well, I've got the first set in the bag, and all of a sudden here he is a set down.
Doesn't help your attitude much, I'll tell you that. But
you really have to regroup.
Sure, but they're both fighters, concentrate well.
Break point for Lendl.
Here's another look, Nuke.
Advantage, Lendl.
Yeah, well, he didn't have much room to work in here because McEnroe got back very quickly. Yvonne hit it a little higher than he intended to, but it worked out well for him.
Great point.
Duke.
A companion of Yvonne Lindell.
That last volley that McEnroe made, he didn't hit it short on purpose, I don't think, but it worked out better for him than had he got a little deeper, Lindell might have gotten his racket on it. Yeah, I don't think I'd like to say he was... Looks nice, doesn't it?
A little water skiing on the sound.
I don't think I'd like to say that McEnroe was nervous on that volley, but it wasn't with the authority that he sometimes is.
Another break point for Lindell. We talked about
advantage Lindell.
Lindell's preference going down the line with a backhand. That was obviously cross court and just hit about as hard as you can hit it. Serve and volley here? I doubt it. Big choice.
Okay, Lindell.
Get out. Lindell gets a break.
Leads 2-love in the second set.
Lindell leads 2-love.
McEnroe's not getting a good percentage of first serves in, and he's paying the price. See his reaction, both feet off the ground. Give the rack a little bounce.
So with a break.
Saw someone do that once, it came up and whacked them right in the chin. Complexion has changed
considerably.
Boy, that's a look at the winners. John McEnroe Sr. Patrick McEnroe on the left of your screen. Obviously concerned at this stage.
Double fault. It's just Lindell's second. 30-15.
good second serve. Punishing.
Going again to the body on the forehand side.
That was so deep with a lot of pace on it. If you keep serving like that, it'll make McEnroe have to change his tactic of trying to come in right off the return, making him start the rally.
There's a cloud hanging over John McEnroe right now as he's serving at love three in the second set to Ivan Lendl. Lendl's won the first 7-6, a tiebreaker, 7 points to one.
15 love.
When was the last time I know that Connors or McEnroe has won the U.S. Open men's final every year since they moved to this place? Well, I'll ask you in a minute. When was the last time two non-Americans won the U.S. Open?
And played in the final?
Right. One.
You mean for men and women?
Men and women, yes.
30.
I don't know.
Nuke, do you know?
I know the last time I won in 73, Margaret Court won.
Well, that's not Americans.
Was it 73?
Was that the last one, though?
That's the last time.
Also, it's the last time a right-hander won.
Here we are, our own John.
Lucky I knew the answer. I had to think for a while. Long time ago.
Mark went to the court part of the line. It's the only mark there. Even though I hit an ace, it has to be second serve. She's sure of a decision. Is there any time where they're not sure of the decision? Has there been one occasion throughout the tournament they're not sure? They're 100% sure every time? Even if it's on the line, they're 100% sure. Is that what they tell them, that they're 100%?
This is where the umpire, Leon Lipp, has to get him going, give him the 30-second warning.
It's been about 55 seconds so far. What are you talking about, 30 seconds?
Yeah.
15 seconds.
One time when we were on a Davis Cup mission, I asked John, I said, when you argue like that, does it ever occur to you that you might be wrong? He said, no.
He was honest.
Yeah.
Okay, McEnroe.
Second ace by McEnroe, that makes it 3-1. Lendl.
Lendl leads 3-1.
Yeah.
quite a few errors flowing from McEnroe's forehand side, Tony.
Yeah, his effort at taking the second serve and come in behind it has not worked lately. It's started out very well. It's fallen off drastically, and part of that is because Lendl has served so well.
The forehand seems to be flying. Most of the mistakes, he's hitting over the baseline.
30 loves.
Be a long way back for McEnroe if he gets down two sets to love. It must have taken a little bit out of him yesterday. He was behind all the way against Volander. Two sets to one and a breakdown in the fourth and the fifth.
40 love.
He's being overpowered at the moment. McEnroe thought it was an ace. It's really easy asking the umpire to overrule on a ball that's so close. They're not supposed to rule on something that's that close.
Was it far enough on the line?
Also, Lendl's waiting for a second serve.
He ought to get two serves. Has given him the point, as I understand it. That's what it looks like.
1-4. We're in the second set. Lendl won the first in the tiebreaker.
Got the ball on a string at the moment. There's Tony Roach.
Love 15.
Doubles partner who's this year taken up the position of acting as Ivan's coach.
Doing a good job.
That's not hand signals. Roachie's not into hand signals.
15 all.
Three aces by McEnroe.
This is telecast is going back to Australia. If people in Australia are thinking that Tony looks very thin, he is. Lendl's got six German shepherds in the house and
they eat all the food?
Roachie's scared to go to the dining room. I think he just locks himself in his room. One area of Lendl's game that they've tried to work on is the volley. As I mentioned before, I think they should be pretty happy with that today so far.
He's also been on a physical fitness campaign. Lost some weight.
And he feels quicker and stronger. McEnroe's first serve has deserted him, so he's given Lendl a lot of swings at the second serve, and Ivan's taking advantage of it. Double break point for Lendl would give him two breaks and a 5-1 lead.
Morning.
McEnroe's only getting around 50%, isn't he, Tony, of first serves into play?
At best.
Yesterday, he averaged 52% against Volander.
56 today. Before this game.
30-40.
He's not winning 50% of his attempts at the net either, and that's unusual for him. He usually is higher than that, but Lendl's been passing so well. But he's below 50% when he goes in. But I would question Yvonne's effort there of hitting that overhead like that.
Was it going in?
I'm not so sure.
It was pretty far back, wasn't he, in the court when he hit it?
So two break points saved by McEnroe. Could have pretty well salted away the second set for Lendl if he'd have been able to get one of those.
Job for McEnroe here is to just try and hang in there at this stage and hope that Lendl cools off a little bit.
Okay, McEnroe. Lendl leads 4-2.
That's a good save in that situation by McEnroe. Lendl's been serving better too. He's only lost a couple of points the last five service games, so he's picked his play up.
What odds on a repeat of the first set the opposite way? It's only one break, isn't it?
Yep.
Even though Lendl has been dominating this set, this is a similar position to what McEnroe found himself in the first set. Pretty good passing shot. Ball actually got a little bit behind him, I think, Tony.
Yeah, he didn't make his normal swing with a topspin. He had almost block it back because he was a little late. Good approach by McEnroe, and that guy really made a shot.
All he could do was watch McEnroe.
Do you think this Lendl is taking probably more time than I've ever seen him take in serving? He usually takes a lot of time, but a little bit more today. Do you think that might be part of a game plan? To play the game to his pace?
Be surprised. He did it in his previous matches too.
Winners 24 for Lendl, 11 for McEnroe. Bounces. 30-15.
Third quarter. the Raiders 28-0 over the Jets.
Been a few surprises so far, haven't there?
Oh, yeah.
Not that that's necessarily a surprise, but...
Houston beating Miami and Minnesota over San Francisco, both big upsets.
Notice that funny thing Lindell does with the two balls?
Why does he do that, I wonder?
So careful looking at me, trying to give some of them. Why don't you start doing some sort of job that resembles umpire?
He's complaining to the umpire that says it's taken 5 minutes between points. That's Leon Lipp. Tough job.
Yeah, I just got some lip.
Every time I want you to count from this point forward. He's going every third, every single point he's going all day.
McEnroe is now talking about what we were talking about just a second ago, about how long Lindell is taking between the getting ready to serve. Sure, he's deliberately trying to slow it down.
Well, it's working because it's making McEnroe mad. Of course, the score is what's making him most angry.
40-30.
I don't know if it's a good idea to make him mad or not.
McEnroe waiting, prancing up and down, and Lindell's just keeping him waiting.
Well, he has 30 seconds.
That's right.
Net. Of course,
at the top of the net.
It's like he's juggling. I don't know
what that is for.
I don't know. He keeps doing it.
And they rub the ball against the shirt. The shirt's wet. It sort of brings the nap down a little bit.
Hey, Lindell.
Lindell leads 5-2 in the second set.
McEnroe serving at 2-5, second set.
With new balls.
Love 15.
McEnroe has been to the net in the second set 21 times, only won 7 points. Very low for him.
Lindell just hammering those returns. McEnroe's up to 68% first serves in the second set. He was down around 50 or so in the first set. He's still in big trouble. Before the match, I asked Bob Howe, the tournament referee, if they have broken the attendance record. He didn't have the figure, but he said yes, by a large margin. They've been huge crowds.
Just about every day it's been
40-30.
Total sellout. Very near. Total attendance, they were talking about getting up close to the 500,000 mark.
Mac and roll.
Lindell leads 5-3 in the second. He won the first set. 7-1 the tiebreaker score.
Lindell leads 5-3.
These are final scores. The Giants shut out Philadelphia 21-0. St. Louis in overtime over Cleveland. New England over Green Bay 26-20. Ivan Lindell serving at 5-3 in the second. He won the first set.
And this is where McEnroe stood in the first set, serving at 5-3 for the set. And at that stage, he had not lost a point on his serve, and he got broken to love.
'84's total attendance here was 431,067.
That's some shot.
That was a very brave shot from Lindell coming in and wing volleying at the ball from the baseline. He got pushed back to the back of the court here. He's in a little bit of trouble at this stage, although good shot here, set it up and then moving in. That's a tough shot to hit.
15 seconds.
Swinging, driving, topspin volley is not what you normally taught.
What was the 15 second call for then?
I guess he was telling him he had 15 seconds to serve.
Right.
Let's. Oh, great shot.
And it's triple set point for Lindell.
What a super passing shot this was from Lindell. A little bit of room across court, so he goes that way. Now, there's just a tiny little bit of room going to be there across court if he can get the topspin on it to bring it down quickly.
15 seconds.
It's the only way you can get that kind of an angle with extra topspin. Macro was really waiting, covering down the line, because he thought Lindell was going to get there late. So we're back live at triple set point.
Did it again.
Same shot. Second set goes to Lindell. Wills at 6-3 and now leads two sets to love. Ivan Lindell.
Seats, please.
Leads John McEnroe two sets to love in the men's final. Pat Summerall with Tony Trabert and John Newcomb.
Love.
Opening day in the NFL, the Minnesota Vikings upset San Francisco 28-21. Detroit over Atlanta 28-27. The Bears beat Tampa Bay 38-28. Pittsburgh 45-3 over Indianapolis. 47-27 Kansas City over New Orleans.
Good net play then from McEnroe, because The last two forehands from Lendl had gone for winners across court. There could have been a temptation to look for that one again.
Seattle beat Cincinnati 28-24, and Houston upset Miami 26-23. 40 love here. McEnroe serving. First game, third set.
It's been an ideal day to play. There is some humidity, but not terribly hot. Not enough breeze to cause any problems.
McEnroe wins the first game of set number three. Leads two sets to love. That's the season premiere.
McEnroe stood way behind the baseline. There's our women's champion in 1985, Hanna Manlikova, and her coach on the right, Betty Stova. Have to be two very, very happy ladies.
Hanna has to be pulling for Yvonne. She's, of course, from Czechoslovakia, and so is he.
That was a strange position for McEnroe to stand in on the previous point. Well, that far behind the baseline.
He's trying to change things up, I guess. Mm-hmm. Take Lendl out of his rhythm.
That's the first one he's really timed for some time.
Gotta give Lendl credit for that, because he's really served well. His second serves have been heavy and deep, and he's mixed it up.
I suppose the other ones were out also. Oh, you know that one was out, right? And I'm supposed to have complete confidence in what you say after you miss blatantly easy shots. I'm supposed to say, oh yeah, you're right. You're right, that one is out. Good job, umpire. Thank you. That's what I'm going to do. Very good job.
It's 40-15.
Game Lendl.
Game Lendl. One all.
Serving a lot of second serves to McEnroe's forehand.
Games are one all.
It's been successful for him.
Indeed it has so far.
McEnroe's made him go for the good second serve because he's been attacking off of it, and Yvonne's responded very well.
Quiet, please. 15 long.
Dane to be going with him getting a lot of first serves into play and coming in for the cross-court volley. Certainly makes a difference when you got a lot of first serves in.
When you're a player that relies so heavily on the serve, as is Macro and Lindell, the better they serve, the higher the rest of their game goes.
I need some good calls,
okay? Best way to get those to hit it in the court, then.
I need some good calls.
All of us do.
McEnroe.
He leads 2-1 in the third set. Roach has been working on that volley. You can see the results.
When you get when you come in on such a good shot, you're pretty apt to get a higher ball to volley. That's why we talk about the approach shot so much.
Press the attack here. That was off a first serve he came in then. Pretty risky against someone who passes as well as Lindell. Well, I guess he's got to do something. Two sets to love down.
Yes, he does.
Would you advise him to do anything different at this stage, Tony, or just keep the game plan up?
I think I'd, particularly off the first serve, I'd try to get it back and play and rally some, try to move him on a rally him, because he's been coming in on some shots that land a little short, and he's been paying the price. Of course, it's easy from up here.
It's hard not to keep up with that game plan of constant attack because it's worked so well for him over the last 2 years against Lindell.
Today's a different day.
Lindell's a better player.
You bet.
Game Lindell.
It's 2-2 in the second set. Fourth ace for Yvonne Lindell.
Game's on 2-2.
Please. Just too good.
Sort of frightening.
Love 15.
Well, he hit one across court a while ago. This one down the line, just as hard and just as effective. Started off in the first few games of the match, didn't he? Just drilling the ball, and we were saying he was sort of flailing at it a little bit, but really got his timing going since 5-3 in the first set.
You need first serves desperately.
He's got a good point there.
McEnroe's never going to be lonely. He talks to himself very well, doesn't he?
He's starting to answer, too. That's what scares you.
Oh.
Desperately is right. He needs first serves right here. See him take a little bit of extra time here. This is a loses this point, it could be just about it.
Keep his concentration.
Talk about taking a long time between serves.
Third, McEnroe lead.
Lendl's gotten in, he's won.
That's fourth quarter score. 28-0 Raiders over the Jets. Denver leading the Rams 16-10. San Diego over Buffalo 14-9. All those in the fourth quarter.
Point now absolutely key for McEnroe.
15 seconds.
I was just thinking he's in the fourth quarter, really. You know, time's running out on him.
15.
Four double faults.
30
for Lindell.
All.
30 all. Men's singles final. U.S. Open of 1985.
Terrific stretch by Lendl.
It was, but it was not a good shot from McEnroe. Let's have a look at what his options are. Certainly not that one. I think he should have probably hit it hard with topspin.
Here's another look.
Good anticipation anyway.
And you see the excited reaction of Ivan Lendl, who's serving at 40-30. Trying to get even at 3-all in the third set.
Game, Lindell.
He gets even at 3-all.
Games are 3-all.
The record before this in U.S. Open Finals, McEnroe 4-0, Lindell 0-3.
Those O's can change the way things are going here.
That first serve.
Flushing Meadows Park was the site of World's Fair back in the early 60s. That was part of it.
To a judge on the head, didn't it?
Yeah. Didn't even look. Didn't even flinch. Too good.
Stepped around that. He was way over in the alley. Took the chance.
30 all.
When you move around a ball like that, you better try to hit a winner because you're opening up the court.
Out. 40. 40. Cheers.
The shot that's been troubling McEnroe all day, the forehand drive. So many of them have gone long over the baseline.
Good chance for Lindell here with a swing of the second serve at deuce.
Advantage McEnroe.
Good second serve.
I think McEnroe fooled him by going out to the forehand.
Had a lot of work on it too, didn't he? A lot of spin.
U.S. Open after this word from your local station. And is serving at 3-4 in the third.
McEnroe would like to do to Lindell what Lindell did to him to French 2 years ago. Come from two sets down and win it in five. Three, six, two, six, six, four, seven, five, and 84 in Paris.
McEnroe got even when they came here in straight sets.
Good high backhand overhead by Lindell. Never seen him do that much, the fist clenching. He obviously wants this badly, as he said earlier. This is not where I was born, but I live here and I like this country and love to win this championship.
He's just really playing well.
I don't think that McEnroe realizes that Lindell's at the net here. She starts back. See, now Lindell comes forward. John thinks he's making an approach shot and looks up, and there's Lindell making a volley.
The ball's past him.
Outsmarted him. That's 40 love.
Talk about fist clenching. I think I've seen more fist clenching at this championship than ever before. Seems to be in vogue today. Maybe Boris Becker started it.
Forehand winners, 14-1. Lindell's favor. John sort of stopped after he made that last shot, just sort of stayed in that corner, almost like he had surrendered the point.
Turned on the lights, they really haven't had a chance to take much effect yet. They are on. Four all, third set.
The second serve was as hard
Games
as his first.
Four all.
Goodyear blimp close by. Shea Stadium in the background, LaGuardia Airport over. Right behind that. McEnroe serving,
ladies and gentlemen.
Four all.
Both players at 57% of first serves at this stage. Not great.
Phil Niekro of the Yankees got his 299th career win. Both the Yankees and Toronto won, so the Yankees are still a game and a half back.
Nine in a row for the Yankees.
15 all.
Another winner by Lendl. Another clenched fist. To that second court, he's been returning the swinging serve very well. It seems to me like McEnroe isn't getting quite as much swing as he normally does, Tony.
Yeah, I think John would be smart to serve it into the body a little bit more, or Yvonne can't take that nice full swing at it.
Keep your eye on McEnroe at the net. Plays the volley. Now the backhand pass. 15, down the line. 30. Now watch McEnroe. He'll make a move. And Lendl just gets his preparation, gets his racket back early. As soon as he sights McEnroe moving to cover the down the line, just flicks it across court.
McEnroe's backhand volley didn't have much on it and was landed short. Gave Lendl one more chance. This is a crucial time here. 4-all, 15-30 in a second serve.
He's fighting rear guard all the time, isn't he? Mm. He was love 30 a couple of games ago. And a second serve.
Ooh, double fault. That's his first one.
And two 15, big 40. Break points. For Lendl. If he comes around serves for the match, he's going to be shuffling those balls in his hand, isn't he?
Yvonne's parents hardly stand to look.
Anticipation.
30-40.
Lendl had a choice. He could go either way with it. McEnroe guessed right. Still break point.
What is it? Something loose in there?
Hey.
Just missed.
Another swing at a second serve.
He's moved around a couple of these. Hit some big forehands down the line. It's in. Slightly mishit. Hey, Roach, you're getting excited there.
15 long.
It was a pretty brave choice of shot, that one, wasn't it? He was off the back foot, a topspin backhand lob.
I'm not sure he meant to do that.
He was just hitting and hoping, you think? Whatever, it came off. Can't get his right shoulder steady.
I can understand why.
Dirty love.
30 long.
Be a lot to celebrate about in Czechoslovakia. Love, Yvonne's parents.
Quiet, please, ladies and gentlemen. Quiet, please.
Triple match point. In 33 minutes. Yvonne Lindell in straight sets. 7-6, 6-3, 6-4. Let's look at match point again. Match point, and Yvonne Lindell has won the U.S. Open of 1985. In very convincing style. We'll be back with the presentation in just a minute. For the award ceremonies, let's go down now to court and Tony Trabert.
Thank you very much, Pat. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a wonderful hand for two great champions, John McEnroe and Yvonne Lindell. To present the checks, it's my pleasure to introduce the CEO and President of Avis, Mr. Pat Barrett. Pat?
Thank you, Tony. Thank you, Tony. Avis, which has been the proud sponsor of the men's singles at the U.S. Open here for the past 10 years, is proud to present this runner-up check to John McEnroe. Congratulations, John.
John, like to say a few words, please.
Well, I don't think I've ever received this much money for losing, so. I want to thank all the sponsors of this event and all my friends who came out here to watch. It looked for a minute here like the ceremony was going to take as long as the match, but I want to thank my parents for having me and giving me this opportunity to be here, and Tatum for being here with me. And finally, congratulate Yvonne in a great match, and I think he deserved the win today.
Now, Pat, I think you have a check for the winner, Yvonne Lendl.
That's right, Tony. The winner's check, ladies and gentlemen, for $187,500.
And now to present the trophy to the winner, the president of the United States Tennis Association, Mr. Randy Gregson. Randy?
Yvonne, congratulations. Two times a bridesmaid, this time you did it. Three marvelous sets of tennis. I think you're looking for this.
Yvonne, the fourth time was the charm. I know this is one you wanted very badly. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I'm very happy that I have won this tournament. I was trying for a long time, and you know, I would like to thank all the people who were helping me in my tries to get this wonderful trophy, and also all the people for coming out here. And I just can't describe how happy I am winning championship of this country.
Thank you very much, Yvonne. Congratulations. And now back to you, Patrick.
Okay, we'll be right back at the National Tennis Center.